are lodging in by the mountainside. In a wild and a lonely spot, not a dwelling house for 5 miles around except her father's cot. On many a pleasant winter's night, young folks would gather there. Her father kept a social house, and she was young and fair. Her father liked to see her dressed as fine as a city belle, for she was the only child that he had, and he loved his daughter well. It was New Year's Eve, the sun was low. Joy beamed in her bright blue eyes as to the window she would go and watch the sleighs pass by. It was New Year's Eve, the sun was low. Joy gleamed in her bright blue eyes. She watched until her true love's sleigh come swiftly riding by. In a village 15 miles away, there's a merry ball tonight. The piercing air is cold as death, but her heart was warm and bright. Oh, daughter dear, her mother said, this blanket around you fold, it's a dreadful night to go abroad, and you'll catch your deathly cold. Oh no, the daughter said, and she laughed like a gypsy queen, for to ride in a sleigh all bundled up, I never shall be seen. My silken coat, it is quite worn, it's lined throughout, you know. Besides, I have a silken scarf which around my neck I'll throw. Her cloak and bonnet soon were on, and they stepped into the sleigh, and around the mountainside they went for many miles away. There's life in the sound of the merry bells as over the hills they go. What a creaking sound the runners make as they bite the frozen snow. With muffled faces silently, over 5 long miles they passed, till Charlie with these frozen words the silence broke at last. Such a night as this I never knew, these lines I scarce can hold. And Charlotte, he said in a very feeble voice, I'm growing very cold. He cracked his whip, he urged his steed much faster than before, saying it's 10 long dreadful miles to go, and it's o'er ice and snow. How fast, says Charles, the frosty ice keeps gathering on my brow. And Charlotte, he said in a very feeble voice, I'm growing warmer now. And they ride through the frosty air and the glittering cold starlight, until at last the village inn and the ballroom are in sight. He drove up to the ballroom door, stepped out and reached his hand. He asked her once, he asked her twice, but she said not a word. Why sit you there like a monument? Within his power to stir, he called her by her name again, still she said not a word. He took her hand in his, oh God, it was cold and hard as stone. He tore the mantle from her brow, and there the cold stars shone. And then into the lighted hall, her lifeless form he bore. Charlotte was a frozen corpse, and words spoke nevermore. Young Charles knelt down all by her side, and the bitter tears did flow. My own, my true intended bride, I never more shall know. He twined his arms around her neck, and the bitter tears did flow, and his thoughts turned back to the place where she said, I'm growing.